Woman and her boyfriend say all of this started in April, and until last week, they were sleeping in their living room to avoid that mold. Lana Becerra moved into her apartment off Berry Road near Waucomas Drive last fall. Come springtime, she and her boyfriend started to notice mold in their bedroom closet. She says it took maintenance a month and a half, but they came in and painted over it.
They assured me that this was going to take care of the problem, that basically that there was nothing, that they told me repeatedly it wasn't dangerous, that only 2% of mold is dangerous and that it can't hurt us.
So Becerra and her boyfriend stayed, despite the fact the mold was growing.
All throughout there's some mold right here.
And for a month and a half, we waited because we thought they were gonna fix it. And then when it hit 2 months, then we were like, okay, we really need to take action here. It was a struggle and arguing back and forth over the phone, basically them telling me it's not their fault.
After both she and her dog became sick, they just moved out.
They told me that I was highly allergic to mold and that I have an infection in my lungs, that all of these symptoms combined with my hives were specifically mold contamination. Our dog has lost fur and patches of fur on her skin, and that is from what we have talked to the vet due to her having allergic reactions to the exposure for mold as well. She's healing now that we're out of that apartment. She's doing better.
Sarah said she technically broke her lease because she refused to sign a document saying she wouldn't pursue legal action.
Within a month, our whole life would turn upside down, and we had to get out of there. That needs to be addressed because we wasted a lot of money living there. And not only that, but it affected our health.
Now, I did speak with the property manager on the phone this afternoon. I told her about this woman's claims, and I told her I'd love to hear the apartment complex's side of all of this. She told me she'd call the regional manager and I'd get a call back, but as of news time, I haven't heard anything. I'm Megan Dillard, Fox 4 News.